Hey guys, Zach back. Thought I'd make a little video today showing my my latest purchases for my knife collection. Nothing real fancy. Some of these I've already did videos on, either different versions of them or yeah, basically different versions of them. But we'll go through that in a second here. The first one I picked up is an old Camillus Boy Scout knife. When I was a kid, almost every boy either wanted one of these or had one of these. And I never had one when I was a kid, never seemed to get my hands on one, so been looking for a while. I picked this one up the other day. Pretty cool knife. It's got the Boy Scout emblem there on the side. It's got your typical Boy Scout blades and tools on it. Has the Camillus style shaped blade there. I don't think you can see it, but on there it says Official Knife, Boy Scouts of America. It has the Boy Scout symbol right there in the middle of the blade. And then it has the awl, which can come in pretty handy for stuff. Pretty neat. And has the bail on the end. Also has the bottle opener / regular screwdriver. Along with the ever-present can opener. Kind of cool little knife. When I see one of these, it takes me back to when I was a kid, you know. I don't know. There's something nostalgic about them, I guess, about the old Scout knives. And since I kind of collect Camillus anyway, when I seen this one, I had to have it. It's not a real fancy version, probably not high dollar. It's not even really that old. Probably, I'd say probably 10 years old, maybe if that. But I didn't have one in the collection, so thought I would go ahead and pick it up. Just kind of neat little knives, part of you know, American history, kind of. But that's the Camillus Boy Scout knife. And all these other three, I did a previous video on these. These are Rough Rider brand knives. This is the three latest ones I picked up. Probably won't pick up any more for a while. I've kind of bought quite a few of these lately, and I think I'll kind of take a break on that. Picked up another medium Stockman. You know, has the typical Stockman blades on it. You got your sheep's foot blade. Your spay blade. Once again, the quality for these things is, you know, amazing. Nickel bolsters, real bone handles. Fit and finish on these things are just outstanding. And I did buy these knives on the auction. I didn't buy these on the buy it now price. The buy it now price tends to be a little higher than what you can actually get them for hump bidding. So far on all the Rough Riders I've had, I haven't had to pay over $9 for any of them. In fact, this one and this one I both got for $7.50 a piece. That's with free shipping. So if you have a little patience, a little diligence, you can get these, you know, fairly, really cheap on eBay. And, you know, pretty cool knives. The price is definitely right on them, and the quality is outstanding. You know, like I said, they are made in China, so if that bothers you, then you might not want to pick one up, but it doesn't bother me. This one here is another Rough Rider. This is what they call the Honeybone Congressman, or Congress style. Has real bone handles. Has four blades, and these blades are all a little bit different shape than your typical pocket knife. Kind of a, that one's kind of a utility blade shape. That one's kind of a spear point. On this side we have another, more of a, I guess you kind of call that somewhat of a spear point blade. And another small spear point. I might have went over the same one twice there. I'm not sure. Well, I kind of lost track. But anyhow, there's four different blades on it. You know, fit and finish on these, on this too is, you know, just amazing. I own, I think, seven of these now, and I've been real impressed with all of them. Just cool little knives, and I'm not going to go into them real detail. Like I said, I got another video that goes over them. Just showing you the latest ones I picked up, and this one I thought was kind of cool. It's just a little dinky sucker. This thing's only like 2¾ inches long. Real bone handle, you know, little Stockman. There again has the typical Stockman style blades on it. It's kind of neat. This one was, one thing that was a little different about this was it does have the file worked back springs on it. I thought that was kind of cool. It's kind of a classy little gentleman's knife. You could throw this in your pocket and wouldn't even realize it was there. But it is dinky. It's about the size of my finger. It's kind of neat. It didn't have nothing of that size in the collection, so I went ahead and picked it up. And this thing was like under six bucks, like $5.66 or something. My bid, I ended up buying this for. Just kind of cool, something different. Now this other one I've had for a while. I just haven't did a video on it, but kind of cool. It's a Western brand boot knife. Got rosewood handle, stainless steel, full tang. These knives were made by Western and Camillus. Camillus used to make a version of this knife too, and I believe, if I'm remembering right, Camillus actually bought Western out before Camillus went under or closed down. So for a while there, Camillus was making the same knife and a few other different versions of the Western brand knives. I think I'm right on that. Just kind of cool. Not real practical. I'm not going to carry this thing around or anything like that. I could. I mean, it is a high quality sheath with a nice heavy spring for either your belt or your boot. It is leather. This metal strap across here kind of acts like a spring and puts tension against the blade to hold that in there. I mean, it's definitely not going to fall out. Pretty simple, but cool design. It actually works very well. Fairly sharp. It's probably 440 stainless or something like that. I'm not sure. It doesn't say on it. But just something kind of different. I don't see a lot of these. I see them once in a while, but I didn't have one, and I thought it'd be cool to add to the collection. It does say Western on the boot clip there, and made in USA, which is always cool. That's always a plus. Pretty neat little knife. The other one here, you guys have seen its brother, or its twin, except for it was in carbon. This is the Mora IQ knife, and I have the carbon version of it, so I thought I'd go ahead and pick up a stainless steel version of it. Not going to go into a lot of detail on this either. My other video kind of covers the basics of it, but this is the same knife, other than a different color, plastic handle, and stainless steel, a 12 C27 Sandvik stainless steel. Great little knives. I just wanted the stainless one because it's a little more water resistant, and I don't have to worry about wiping the blade down every time I use it or anything like that. And didn't have one. I liked its other, the other version of it well enough that I went ahead and picked this one up to add to the collection. Mora's standalone as far as quality for the price. Most everybody out there knows about the Mora knives, but if you haven't experienced, haven't had any experience with any Moras, you really need to buy a couple of them and check them out, because they are one of the best buys you can buy in a knife, as far as I'm concerned. The price is just amazing for the blade steel you get, the edge retention. Everybody knows the story of the Moras, so I'm not going to try not to go over all that again, but great little knives. Can't beat them. But anyhow, I just wanted to make a quick little video there and show you what I picked up lately. Nothing fancy. Just some new additions to the old knife collection. So I want to appreciate you guys subscribing and watching my videos. I'm going to try and get out here in the future and actually do some shooting videos. A few more gun-related videos. Haven't had the chance lately to get out there and do that, but I want to do some shooting videos, take you guys out, and that way you're not just staring at my tabletop reviews all the time. Add something a little different to it, but really appreciate you guys subscribing and commenting, and try to come up with some new videos and some different stuff to keep you guys interested, but I appreciate you watching, and thanks for tuning in.